Hey guys, it's Joey again from the Technical Account Management team. In the last installment of the series, we had just finished deploying our network edge device, which should be fully provisioned now. So I'm going to go ahead and jump over to the device to check up on its status. Awesome. So you can see here that it's fully provisioned. And what I want to do next is look down at these details and find its IP address. So I'm actually going to go ahead and copy this. And what we're going to do next is go ahead and take a look at PuTTY. So here in PuTTY, I am going to go ahead and enter in that IP address that we just pulled. And the next thing I'm going to do is expand this menu under SSH, head over to auth, and I'm going to browse for the private key portion of that SSH key pair from when we provisioned our device. So I'm going to add that. I'm going to head back over to the session tab. And I'm going to give this a name. Let's just name it Community SSH. And I'm going to hit save. And so all that's going to do is just make it so that next time we come back here, we don't have to enter that information again. So now all we have to do here is select our Community SSH session and press open. And if you'll remember, when we were creating our device, the username that we went with was community. So there we go. We are in. Next, I'm going to just type in show IP interface brief. I'm just curtailing that command. And there are our interfaces. Awesome. So there you have it, guys. We successfully SSH'd into our Cisco router. Again, these are very, very short and sweet videos. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. And in the next one, we are going to take a look at Azure, where we are going to begin building a virtual connection to an express route. I will see you guys in the next one.